Good morning students, welcome back to the online classes of science. In our previous video, what we have learned? How to make a homemade torch, isn't it? In that homemade torch, what we are doing? We are just wrapping a wire on the bulb and the next wire, end of the wire to the cell, and while touching on the tip of the cell, the bulb will glow. When we will take it off, the bulb will get off, right? So today we will learn how to make a switch in that. Okay, so let's start the 12.4 electric switch. We had an arrangement for switching on or off our homemade torch by moving the base of the bulb away from the tip of the cell. As I told you before, that while touching the tip of the cell, the bulb is getting on, and we will take it off. At that time, the bulb will get off. Like this, we are just glowing a bulb. Like this, we have made our torch, isn't it? This was a simple switch, but not very easy to use. We can make another simple and easier switch to use in our circuit. See, that was a simple, but not very easy to use for. So we are making another switch in a simple way. Let's start the activity 4. You can make a switch using two drawing pins, a safety pin, or a paper clip. See, with the help of the two drawing pins, a safety pin, if safety pin is not available, you can use a paper clip, two wires, and a small sheet of thermocol or a wooden board. See, those all things are used to make the switch. Insert a drawing pin into the ring at one end of the safety pin and fix it on the thermocol sheet as shown in the figure 12.8. See, this is the figure 12.8. What you have to do? You have to take one sheet. In that, you have to attach the two drawing pins along with the wire. In one drawing pin, you have to attach the safety pin also, like this. Okay. Make sure that the safety pin can be rotated freely. See what they are telling, that while making this type of attachment, the safety pin should be moved freely. It should be moved freely. How? Like from here, if you will touch it over here, again we have to take it back. So like this, the safety pin should be moved. So we have to check whether it's moving freely or not. Now fix the other drawing pins on the thermocol sheet in a way that the free end of the safety pin can touch it. See what they are telling. Now we are talking about this other drawing pin. How we have to attach this? We have to attach in a proper way that the other end of the safety pin should touch it freely. Now the safety pin fixed in this way will be your switch in this activity. See what they are telling, that while putting the safety pin like this on the thermocol sheet with the help of the two drawing pins and a wire, this will work as a switch in our activity. How it will work, that we have to see. Now make a circuit by connecting an electric cell and a bulb with this switch as shown in the figure 12.9. See. Like this. What we have to do? The one end of the wire, we have to wrap it with this one, the bulb, and the other end with this one, cell. Okay? Where we have kept the pin and the drawing pin, we have to attach the other wire over here. And when we will move the switch, how we will move the switch? Let me tell you. This, the safety pin, you have to move on this direction. When it will touch over here, the bulb will glow. Clear? So now make a circuit by connecting an electric cell and a bulb with the switch as shown in the figure 12.9, as I have shown you how to attach that all things. Rotate the safety pin so that it freely and touches the other drawing pin. See what they are telling, that we have to rotate this pin. Which pin? This one, this pin, we have to rotate it. So when it will touch over here, the bulb will glow. What do you observe? Now move the safety pin away. Does the bulb continue to glow? See what they're telling that way. In previous activity, what we were doing, we are just touching on the tip of the cell. Okay. So while doing that, the bulb get glow. And in this one, as it's a electric switch. So in this, what we are doing, we are just moving a safety pin. We are just rotating a safety pin. When it will touch to the other drawing pin, the next drawing pin, at the time the connection will flow from the wire and the bulb will glow. When we will take it off the pin, the bulb will off. The safety pin covered the gap between the drawing pins. When you made it touch two of them, see what they are telling, that the safety pin should cover the gap between the two drawing pins. Okay, when we are making that, we have to be very careful that the gap should be filled. In this position, the switch is said to be on. See, in this position, as shown in the figure 12.10, a switch is on. Here the switch is on. Getting? See, the pin is touched with the other drawing pin. So, between that, the gap is filled with that pin. Okay. So, here it is on. Toy. The circuit was complete, hence the bulb glow. See, after doing this process, after making the switch on, the bulb will get glow. On the other hand, the bulb did not glow when the safety pin was not in touch with the other drawing pin. See what they are telling, that the bulb will not glow. When it will not glow? When the safety pin is not touched with the other drawing pin. The circuit was not complete as there was a gap between the two drawing pins. This position, the switch is said to be off. See what they are telling, that at that time, see, like this. This is the position, the off position. Okay. If the gap is not filled between the two drawing pins, the switch is off. And when the gap is filled between the two drawing pins, the switch is on. Clear? A switch is a simple device that either breaks a circuit or completes it. See what they are telling, that it's a simple device. If it's in this position, it's a complete circuit. If it's in this position, it's an incomplete circuit. That means it's in a off position. The switch used in lighting or electric bulb and other device in homes work on the same principle, although their designs are more complex. See what they're telling, that the switches that which we are having at our home, they are also having the same principle. They are also working in the same way, but they are designed in a very complex way. Okay, so we are having a confusion that how it's working or how the work is going on in this switch. But it's very simple. So whatever the things today we have done, it's having the same principle. Clear? So we'll stop over here, students, and just go through it, just revise it, and just try to understand the position of the switches when it's on and off. Okay. So that's all for the students. Have a good day.